Hi there, this is Dr. Evan Osar with the Institute for Integrative Health and Fitness Education. Welcome to this edition of Integrative Movement Insider. Welcome to Tuesday, day one of a five-part series, part one of a five-part series that we're sharing with you on Knee 101. Because so many of our clients, especially the general population client and the older clients, will present to us with both osteoarthritis and or joint replacements. And this topic really comes around the fact that my mother-in-law is about to have her knee replaced. I think it's next week. And my wife, Janice, will head up there and be with her for a few days. And obviously there'll be a lot of rehab associated with her knee replacement. But here's a challenge. Because of insurance changes, my mother-in-law is going to be sent home, supposed to be sent home the exact same day she has a knee replacement. Now this is my mother-in-law's 16th, 17th, or 18th knee surgery. She's already had the other knee replaced. So what's the likelihood she's going to be in a good position to be successful if she's sent home the exact same day that she's just had major surgery? Think about it for yourself, young, healthy, fit fitness professional, or maybe a middle-aged or older fitness professional. Think about having major surgery, and now they're gonna send you home because insurance doesn't wanna cover excessive days in the hospital. And that's what we're seeing so frequently here in our own clinic with our clients. They're having surgery, or they're going through rehab and they're getting cut off very quickly. In fact, right now, the average physical therapy visit, the number of visits that people are getting for physical therapy, regardless of their condition, is 6 to 12 visits max. So where that leaves our clients is they need an expert to help them accomplish their health and fitness goals, especially when they leave rehab after having rehab for surgery or chronic injuries, tightness, discomfort. They need that expert, that specialist to go to help them get towards accomplishing their health and fitness goals. So while that's bad news, the way our insurance companies or the insurance industry is set up, it's great news for you and I as healthcare professionals and health and fitness professionals, I should say, because these individuals are going to seek out the services of someone who understands exactly how to work with them. And that's why I'm excited to share this topic with you, Knee 101, so that way you have the perspective so that you can develop your expertise and be the solution that these individuals need, want, and will pay for. So we want to share with you what osteoarthritis is and how it starts, so that way you can help educate your clients. And then if your clients have had surgery and or joint replacements, help give them a successful and safe strategy for getting back to the things they need to, want to, and or love to do. So we're going to discuss briefly here the degenerative joint process. And it basically starts around this concept of habits. We've all created posture and movement habits around things we've seen, heard, learned, around conversations around injuries, traumas, surgeries, as well as things we've learned about cueing. We've talked many times in Integrated Movement Insider about the cues and how we've all been taught, or many of us have been taught, to stand up tall, bring the chest up, squeeze the shoulder blades down and back, pull the abs in, squeeze the butt and tuck under, and these create postural and movement changes that then affect and impact our soft tissue. So it creates soft tissue changes, and then ultimately, if these habits are kept up long enough and they're these non-optimal and inefficient habits, that's what ultimately leads to the degenerative process where you start to wear down the cartilage, start to create soft tissue changes, and then start to create bony changes, that thing that we ultimately call or your doctor diagnoses as osteoarthritis. And ultimately then, if it gets too advanced, that's where you start to get joint replacements. So it's very important that you understand that process, that it starts out with non-optimal and inefficient habits that we've all created around compensations. And then it develops into soft tissue changes, so muscle and joint, I should say muscle, fascia, ligamentous, joint capsule type issues, and then we start to create the bony changes, the thing that we actually look at an x-ray or MRI and say you have osteoarthritis. So the most important strategy you have to help these individuals is right here. Help your clients develop more optimal and efficient habits. So as we go along through the series, I'm gonna share with you how you help your clients first, identify their non-optimal and inefficient habits that are leading to these issues, these osteoarthritic and joint replacement type issues, or why they needed a joint replacement, and then help them then use corrective exercise, the integrative movement system, corrective exercise strategy, to help them create more optimal and more efficient habits around posture movement so they can ultimately accomplish, safely and successfully accomplish their health and fitness goals. So pay attention or stay tuned for this series. So part two will be coming later this week. Janice and I will be teaching in Orlando, Florida. So if you are there, at SJW Mania. Stop by, say hello. We love to meet people live. We love to communicate via Facebook and the internet and social media. However, we love meeting people live. So if you're in Orlando, come by and say hi. And if you're looking for an inclusive training program, we have the Integrative Corrective Exercise Instructor Program that we're bringing to Orlando later this summer. So check that out as well for a complete resource. However, stay tuned for part two coming this Friday. Janice and I will be on live, Facebook Live, this coming Friday, and all our videos are recorded and put on our website. So if you miss it, no worries, it's on our website and our YouTube channel. This is Dr. Evan Oso with the Institute for Integrative Health and Fitness Education. Thanks again for joining me, and look forward to part two coming this Friday. Make it a great week.